Okay. All right. So let's start out.
Picking up the music alone.
Oh, no, it's
picking
fine.
Up the life of Harlem.
Here we go.
More to Harlem than just us breathing.
True that. Hello. There we go.
All right, now you're ready. Just share your thoughts. Go back and forth. I feel like it shouldn't be like, yeah.
We're going to start this way.
Okay.
It won't be 10 years.
Right, that's true.
Because I know I've been on Earth a while.
Yeah.
And I know I've been to the rodeo.
I went to St. Louis, Missouri the other day. They had Black Panthers from all over the country. No one knew about it at all. They had machine guns, recoilless rifles, grease guns, Lugans, 25 of them, all armed. And the chief of police met me at the airport when I arrived, and they were there, right there at the steps. He said, "You were violating the law." "Yeah, we're violating the law." He said, "We're tired of our white and black leaders, Jackie and Martin and Bobby, being killed. We're going to protect this man while he's here." And they didn't arrest one of them. Because they said, if you arrest one, then someone's going to die because we are ready to kill.
Let's get the history on it.
Okay, Adam Clay Powell was a congressman.
Oh.
He was the pastor of Abbey City Baptist Church,
mm-hmm.
which is located
yes.
in Harlem. His father was also the pastor. And he married, he had a thing for showbiz women.
Yeah. Well, Scott was a piano player.
He's a Scott. He was married to one of the Washington, Isabel and Freddie Washington.
I heard a rumor
yeah.
that Adam Clay Powell used to come to this very place we are now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And he would sit at the end of the bar. This used to be a bar.
Yeah, yeah.
And he would order his drinks and sit and chit-chat with the folks. And I don't know if it's true or not. I wasn't here. But a lot of people, a lot of elders came and told me that this place, Starbucks, used to be a bar.
Yeah.
And a lot of greats came here, a lot of jazz musicians, but Adam Clayton Powell was known for coming here. And he had a third seat at the bar. Everybody knew it.
Nice.
And he'd come here and he'd buy drinks for everybody. And he'd listen to people's problems. You could go to his office and say, "You don't have heat," or "Someone, there's a problem in the community."
Yeah.
He'd get on the phone yeah. and handle it right away. What I love most about the statue is as you walk around this statue,
yeah.
you can read the history of everything that he did.
Yeah.
From the time he ran, from the time he left, and every bill he got passed, you'll find out so much that you just never knew.
Black power means black dignity. Just as surely as you're proud to be white, we're proud to be black. Black is beautiful, baby. It's pretty. I always say to my brothers, I say, "Baby, don't worry about the white chicks. We got everything from chalk to charcoal in our own race." You know, see? Black is beautiful. Black is beautiful. Black power means dignity. It means we're going to walk side by side with you or through you. We're going to be with dignity and integrity. We don't want any more than you have. And we're not going to accept any less than you have. That's Black power.
From Anthony.
Yeah, go
yeah.
for it.
I think in modern day today, a lot of the younger generation hasn't been taught enough about the history of black people and their brilliance of who we are.
Yeah.
And a lot of the younger generation nowadays have actually kind of ran down the brilliancy of who black people are to the point where we've kind of like lost respect of who we are as a great people.
Mm.
And they're not, when they do see statues like Adam Clayton Powell, they don't acknowledge it or idolize it to understand that if it wasn't for people like him, we wouldn't even have what we have here today.
Yeah.
Of me, and you give me all of you.
Man, last night was crazy. It was so, like, I never really experienced being in that setting with the police officers.
Oh, that's insane.
I'm like, really? I'm like, are you guys? They started backing off once they realized how educated we are.
That's exactly
and
it.
And what we knew, what we're saying. I'm just like, this is just making this into a bigger deal than it is.
Mm-hmm.
The guy, pretty much, you tried tricking him.
Mm-hmm.
The undercover cop. Now at least knowing what these undercover cops look like.
Yeah.
Ridiculous. And just like, we were actually trying to see something, knowing that he was going to be able to go through either way.
Mm-hmm.
But he's just like, yo, try to calm with us. All right, calm down, calm down. I'm calm.
Yeah, hey, I don't know, I was probably thinking of it wrong. I'm calm. Don't tell me to calm down when I don't have to calm down. You guys need to calm because your buddy's trying to pull him away. If he touched him, oh my god. That's what it's getting down to.
Yeah.
Like, well, get over here. Get over here. Why you gotta talk to him personally?
Exactly.
Doesn't make any sense.
You're talking to him like he's a fucking, like,
his child. Yeah.
I'm like, that's crazy.
Like, listen, I am one. I was so happy to see this. I'm like, I'm paying your salary because lately, I'm from Canada. We all have our taxes and everything. But New York has its own separate taxes.
Yeah.
And I'm looking at it. I'm like, yo, this is like taking out of my paycheck. It's like $100 taken out of my paycheck for taxes alone.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm just like, okay, you know what? If I'm paying these taxes, then police officers or whoever is working for the government
Yeah.
better be doing the job freaking right because I'm paying for this shit.